Hi guys, my name is Jakub Paszkiewicz and I come from Poland. We are in my workshop now and today I'd like to show you how I make one of my pipes. So stay with me and enjoy.
I'd like to apologize up front for the video quality and my poor accent. So as you may see, I have drawn just a few supporting lines. Later on you will be able to see what I use them for. Now I just need to remove the excess material. But before we go any further, I believe it's a perfect moment to say just a few words about briar. So briar is a tree which grows all over the Mediterranean. Pipes are made of the underground part of a tree, and it takes about 30-40 years before it's good enough for briar blocks. I buy my briar directly from Mimo Romeo. He's one of the finest briar cutters, but because I don't want you to bore you to death, so if you have any questions about briar, feel free to ask them in comments. I've sped up the video slightly. I had to do it in many parts of this video, and I also tried to minimize my comments as the video is worth 1,000 words. And right now you can see as I'm turning down the future shank. Now I drill a draft hole. It's very important to do it right. Obviously, with a pipe like this, a straight pipe, it's fairly easy to achieve. And here I drill out a mortise where tenon will fit in. What you see now is ebonite rod, which I use for my stems. Sometimes I use Cumberland as well. Basically, ebonite and Cumberland are similar. I don't use acrylic, and I believe it's a matter of a personal taste. Anyway, I have just drilled out the pilot hole with 1/16 drill bit, and now I flipped it around and I'm going to drill a second hole, a larger one. And as you may see, this drill bit tapers at the end. It's a modified bit specially for that purpose. I do that because a sharp edge at the at the junction of these two holes is the last thing I need. A sharp edge would result in an obstacle for smoke where moisture could build up from condensation. And now I'm turning down the tenon, which will fit into the mortise. Now I turn down both stem and shank alike. I have put aside roughly shaped stem for a moment because I'm going to drill the chamber. So we need to be sure that the draft hole and the chamber will meet up properly. Thank you. And now I will be turning down the bowl. I will be repeating the same thing over and over until I receive desired shape. And now I'm shaping the rim. For me, personally, flat rims are a bit boring, so most of my pipes have slight dome in this place. And this is final 600 grit. Using sanding wheel can be tricky sometimes. A slight moment of distraction can result in destroying your pipe. That's why I protect the bowl and the shank with some kind of a masking tape. As sanding wheel is very helpful, it won't do the whole job. For final finish I use abrasives, last grit I use is 600. And here is another sanding wheel which I use to shape stems mostly. It requires a lot of practice, but it's totally worth it. Now I use files for final stem shaping. It's a pretty long process and you can see only last couple minutes of it. In a moment you'll see almost finished stem, and I said almost because I'm postponing button shaping deliberately, and I will explain it in a moment. Now I use a Dremel tool to cut the beginning of the slot, and right after I will use simple drill bit to start cutting the funnel shape. And while it's done, I'll switch to needle file to clean the slot. Here you can see as I'm wet sanding the stem up to a 1000 grit, and after it's done it will be ready for buffing. Thank you. And now I sand the slot as well, and it serves one purpose only: laminar flow with no disruptions. Now you can see the last stage of contrast staining process. It's very complex and long-lasting. The main purpose of it is to bring out the grain. So I have already put a few layers of undercoat, and now I'm going to buff it off. The reason for which I shaped the button at the very end of the whole process is to preserve sharp edges. It's not the only way, but I find it very efficient. As you can see, the bowl has changed and it doesn't resemble the one you saw a couple minutes ago. I have removed the undercoat almost entirely. Thanks to it, a beautiful grain has emerged. And now there are only two more steps left. Final buffing, which you can see right now, is one of them. And the last step is waxing with Carnauba. I always put few thin coats instead of one and thick. Carnauba gives this desired mirror finish. After that, pipe is almost ready. So there it is, pipe is finished. Thanks for spending time with me, and I hope you have enjoyed watching my video.